Midway through their second decade, hybrids have reached a critical juncture in the United States. While their technology is going to become increasingly important as automakers push to meet regulatory targets, gas prices, adjusted for inflation, are at their lowest consistent point since 2003. The latest Toyota Prius has embraced space oddity styling, but that doesn't appear to be spurring sales of that hybrid icon. The new Kia Niro, on the other hand, looks like the kind of vehicle that can inspire Americans to trade in their compacter midsize sedans. The Niro is an approachable and practical, crossover-like hatchback, one that just happens to have a hybrid powertrain and EPA city ratings of up to 52 miles per gallon. Refreshingly straightforward, it has no unfortunate packaging concessions, no bizarre styling, and no weird controls that are different just for the sake of being different. We're looking at you, Prius shifter. Blending in. The Niro is built on a dedicated compact hybrid vehicle platform shared with the Hyundai Ioniq. However, while the Ioniq sticks with the Prius-like cam back profile designed to squeeze the last tenth of a mile out of every gallon of gasoline, the Niro trades off some aerodynamic efficiency for greater passenger and cargo space. For the US market especially, we think Kia made a smart choice. From across the parking lot, the Niro looks like a crossover SUV. Step closer, and it is clearly lower and more wagon-like. It has a slightly higher riding alternative to the Toyota Corolla M or the Ford Focus hatchback, yet it has lower and more squat than many small crossovers such as the Chevrolet Trax, Honda HR-V, Mitsubishi Outlander Sport, or Fiat 500X. Seat height is about an inch and a half higher than that of a typical compact sedan, according to Kia, and slightly lower than the Solas, perfect for easy entry and exit. There is enough headroom and legroom in back for tall adults, and the rear seat backs flip forward, creating a flat cargo floor. Echo every time. The Niro, like Kia's optimal hybrid, has a four-cylinder engine and a single AC electric motor, generator integrated within a six-speed automatic transaxle. But much is different about both the engine and the gearbox. The engine is a new Atkinson Cycle 1.6-liter four-cylinder with exhaust heat recovery and dual cooling circuits for quickly warming up the cylinder head. It makes 104 horsepower and 109 pounds-to-foot of torque, and Kia claims it operates with 40% thermal efficiency, a lofty mark on that scale. The six-speed is a dual-clutch unit, with two hydraulically actuated multiple tri-clutches finessing launches and shifts. The combined system output to the front wheels is 139 horsepower and 195 pounds-to-foot of torque. In case you missed any previous hints that this is not a rugged SUV, note that all-wheel drive is missing from the lineup, and there are no plans to add it. Kia suggests that the dual-clutch gearbox at the core of the Niro S powertrain layout makes for a more engaging driving experience. But with every startup and shift into drive, the Niro defaults to its Eco Mode A setting that prefers higher gears, delivers sluggish downshifts, and inch stabs of the accelerator bring a long pause before anything happens. Start off gingerly enough to avoid waking the gasoline engine, and you'll probably be irritating the traffic behind. The Niro is fairly aggressive about shutting down the gasoline engine when you re-crawl in a long and dense traffic or in city driving at less than 30 miles per hour or so. Sliding the shift lever over to the left engages the Niro S perkier sport mode, with somewhat firmer steering, sharper accelerator response, and a dramatically different shift schedule. You'll pay a mileage penalty using that mode, as it keeps the engine running the vast majority of the time. And with a 0-60 mph time expected to be on the far side of the 10-second mark, about the same or slightly slower than the Prius, the Niro still isn't quick. The one drivability aspect we found a little off-putting was the complete lack of engine braking. In sport, you can pull the shifter back to downshift a gear or two to manage speed down a long grade, for instance. You'll hear the engine revving higher, but there is no significant deceleration. Nor is there any sign of increased regenerative braking on the in-dash readout. We also experienced a few powertrain jitters and uncouth transmission sounds. Unlike Toyota, Hyundai, Kia DO&T have 20 years of experience with hybrid system software mapping, and it can show in that way. That said, the Korean companies have made tremendous progress in hybrid drivability in a relatively short period, including the Niro S-Great Battlefield blending regenerative and mechanical braking. The Niro also exhibits good ride, handling, and NVH qualities. Although it DO&T feel overtly sporty, on the South Texas backroads where we drove the Niro, we found good body control and a lack of the queasy rebound moments that you find in some crossovers. The steering is nicely weighted and requires very few corrections to maintain a straight path on the highway. A rubber-isolated front subframe helps keep vibrations and harshness from reaching the cabin, and all Niro models have an acoustically insulated windshield. No hybrid would be complete without some eco-jeep goodies, although the Niro generally keeps such things rather subtle. Grille shutters automatically close at approximately 35 miles per hour to diminish drag, and the Niro has a host of underbody airflow smoothing items, including an air deflector for the muffler. The available navigation system accesses GPS data for road topography and can advise the driver when to lift off the gas, such as when going down hills or exiting freeway ramps, and can direct the powertrain to shunt electrons to pre-charging the battery pack in anticipation of long uphill grades. It all adds up to exemplary fuel economy ratings, 52 miles per gallon city and 49 miles per gallon highway for the miserly Fay version, 51/46 of a mile per gallon for the LX and X models at the heart of the lineup, and 46/40 of a mile per gallon for the touring models we drove. That has a significant difference in mileage across versions with seemingly minor differences. Kia says that all of the core hybrid components remain the same but point to the Touring S nearly 170 pounds of extra equipment and wider tires, 225/45R18 versus 205/60R16. The Niro will start reaching US dealerships in January. All models get rear-view camera and a 7.0-inch infotainment system with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto connectivity. Compared with the more affordable LX, the X model makes a significant step up in terms of interior comforts, adding standard heated front seats, rear AC vents, upgraded trim, and an available sunroof. Touring models upgrade their audio significantly with an 8-speaker Harman Kardon system and also get power front seats and leather upholstery. Adaptive cruise control and automated emergency braking are among the features available on top X and Touring models. As with the Hyundai Ioniq, this hybrid version is only one iteration of Kia's Green Machine. A plug-in hybrid Niro is due to arrive next September, and an all-electric variant is expected to complete the family, likely in early 2018. In the meantime, those who choose a Niro because it is the size and shape they want probably will find a lot of value in this model, as generally pleasant driving experience and roomy interior, not to mention a lot more monetary value should gas prices rise.